यस सर।
So in the last class, we have started the concept of linked list, right?
Yes, sir.
What is a linked list? What is a linked list? Anybody?
Collection of nodes.
Yeah, collection of nodes, and we have seen gone through this. What are the various applications of linked list? What are the applications of linked list?
Insertion and deletions.
Now that is the advantage of linked list. I'm asking you what
implementation are the... implementation of stacks and queues.
Okay, implementation of stacks and queues. Can you see the screen? Why linked list?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So it is used to implement stacks, queues, graphs, hash tables, B plus trees, memory management. So it has lot of applications we have for these linked lists, right? If anybody asks you what are the advantages of these linked lists, then you have to go and tell that the insertion and deletion of nodes in the linked list is an easier process. That is the reason why we go for linked lists, right? So in the last class, we have discussed this particular topic also, arrays versus linked lists. So what is the first difference we have? Arrays are linear data structure, whereas linked lists neither be treated as linear nor non-linear, right? And there is a concept of indices in the arrays, and there is no concept of indices in the linked lists. And elements in arrays can be randomly accessed by making use of these indices. This point we have already discussed. And the accessing of elements in the linked list is only possible in the sequential fashion. This is also we have discussed. And one more point is elements are stored in the contiguous memory locations, but coming to the linked list, the elements may not be stored in the contiguous memory locations. May not be means it may be stored or it may not be stored in the contiguous memory locations, right? So insertion of elements require more time. Why? Because you need to create the space. So insertion of an element at the end of the array is an easier process, but insertion of an element in the middle, you need to create the space. For creation of space, you have to move all the elements towards its right hand position. So it takes a lot of time. But whereas coming to the linked list, the insertion process is very easy. You need to modify some pointers, thereby you can insert a node into the middle of the linked list. Similarly, the deletion of elements from the middle of the array is a complex task. It also requires more time. Why? Because whenever you remove an element from the middle of the array, there will be a hole that is created there. So in order to fill that hole, you have to move all the elements towards its left hand side. So it requires a lot of time. Whereas coming to this linked list, the deletion operation is a very easier operation, right? And memory allocated for this array will be at the compile time. Therefore, we call this as static memory allocation. And the memory allocated for the nodes in the linked list will be at the runtime. We call this as, what is this called? Memory allocated at runtime is called as?
Dynamic memory allocation.
Dynamic memory allocation, so far, right. So use a static memory allocation techniques, this also we have discussed. And linked list makes use of dynamic memory allocation, so we need to use some predefined functions such as malloc, calloc, and realloc, and here it is not delete, it is free. Right. So there is no memory wastage in the array if the array is full. Otherwise, they may result in the wastage of memory. But when considered, when you consider the linked list, there will be some extra storage that is needed for the references. Right. This also we have discussed with an example, right? So after this, we have gone through the definition. A data structure consists of a group of nodes that forms a sequence. and linked list comprise of group of list of nodes in which each node have a link to the next node to form a chain, right? So very common data structure that is used to create the stacks, queues, trees, graphs. So you take any abstract data type, you take any data type or any data structure you want to implement, you can implement it by making use of linked list, right? So a linked list can be taken as a series of nodes or a collection of nodes. Each node consists of two parts. As I told that this is not limited to only two parts. You can divide the node into any number of parts depending upon the application you are developing. Sometimes you require the node to be divided into three parts. Yes, you can do it. Sometimes you require the node to be divided into four parts. Yes, you can do it. Like that, based upon the application, you can divide the node into more than two parts also, right? But in singly linked list, we will be dividing the node into only two parts. The first part is called the data part, and second part is called the pointer part or address part or reference part. It has lot many number of names, but all those names refer to the pointer only. All those names refer to the address only. So everything is same, right? So the pointer part stores the address of the next node. This is what we have discussed. What does the data part store? What does the data part store?
Actual value.
Actual data.
So it stores the actual value, right?
Yes.
I'm not getting any responses from the girls. Ma, meer class vintunnara leda?
Vintunnam
sir. Ma response So this is how we represent a node diagrammatically. The entire part is called as a node. As I told that the node is divided into two parts, value part and address of the next node, right? The same thing we are going to discuss here. And here comes the types of linked lists. The first category of linked lists we have is singly linked lists. As the name itself specifies that it consists of a single link. That means it consists of only a single address part. So we need to divide the given node into two parts. One part is a mandatory part. Whatever linked list you take or whatever implementation you make, one part is a mandatory part, that is the value part, where you are going to store the actual value. But the remaining parts may vary, right? So since it is a singly linked list, it stores the address of only one node, which is the next node to that particular node, right? So it has only single address. It has only single address, and that address is to the next node. Therefore, it is called as a singly linked list, right? So it provides access to the list from the head node itself. We'll discuss what this head node is. Right. Once we go to the programming, we'll discuss what this head node is. So head node is a very important node. In fact, this is not considered to be a node. Right. It is a pointer. It is just a pointer. So this pointer is responsible to hold the address of the first node of the singly linked list. For example, let me take three nodes like this. Right. What is the base address? Here it is 200, 200, and this is 300. So let me store 200 here. Therefore, we create a link here. Similarly, let me store 300 here. We create a link from node 2 to node 3, and this is null. What is the address part of the last node?
Null, sir.
Null, sir. Null.
So null indicates that is the end of the linked list. So how many nodes are created here? Three nodes.
Three, sir.
First node is at base address 100. Second node is at base address 200. The third node is at base address 300, right? Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Right. So how can I identify that this node, which is created at 100 base address, is the starting node? So how can I identify that this is the starting node? So in order to identify the starting node of a linked list, which consists of n number of nodes, I have to create a pointer. I have to create a pointer called as head pointer. What is that pointer called?
Head, sir.
Head pointer, right? So I will store the address of the starting node inside this. So when I store the starting address of the linked list in the head pointer, I am going to make the pointer to point to this first node, right? So by looking at head, by looking at the value at the head, or by looking at the address of this head, I can identify that the base address 100 consists of a node which is considered to be the first node of the linked list. So this part is very, very, very important. Creating a head node or creating a head pointer is very, very important. What is the importance of head node? Can anybody tell me? Just now I have told.
Tells the base address of the linked list.
No, it is not the exact wording. So the head node stores the address of the first node of the linked list. So what is the use of this head node means? The head node is used to access the linked list. Right? Head node is used to access the first node of the linked list. This is the advantage of head node. So you cannot create a linked list without this head node. You can create. But without creating this head node and without making this head node pointing to this linked list, you cannot perform any operation on the linked list. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So if somebody asks you what is the importance of head node, you have to tell that the head node stores the starting address of the address of the starting node. And the second point is the head node indicates the first node of the linked list, right? So where we are going to store the first value or what is the first node of the linked list is identified by the head node only. That is the role of this head node. So without this head node, no other operation can be performed. Why? May I know the reason? Anybody, any wild guess you have? You can just post it. I'm saying that the head node, without head node, I am not going to perform any operation on the singly linked list. I cannot perform any operation on the singly linked list. May I know the reason? Do you know or don't know? Or if you don't know, just give me a wild guess, or you tell me, I don't know. That's it. Super. You are somewhat closer to the answer. As I told that any operation that you perform on the singly linked list should be from the starting node itself, right? You cannot perform any operation from the middle of the linked list. Any operation that you perform on the linked list should be from the starting node only. So for this reason, you have to store the address of the starting node in a pointer called head. So thereby the programmer can identify that the starting node is located at so and so address. By this, he can perform any operation, right? So the reason is any operation that you perform on the singly linked list should always start with the starting node only. So in order to identify the starting node, I have to store the address of the starting node in a pointer variable. That is the reason why I am going to include the head pointer, which always points to the first node, right? You cannot change the value of this head node. It should be always pointing to the address of the first node only. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Right. So in the singly linked list, the second point is the traversal is allowed only one way and there is no going back. That means if I want to go to this third node, where should I start my operation? Where should I start my operation if I want to go for the third node?
From head node.
From head node.
From the starting node where I have accessed the starting node from the head, right? So I access this element and then I go via this link and I access the second element. And from second node to third node, I go via this link and I can access the third node, right? So you cannot go back from 30 node 3 to node 2. Similarly, you cannot go back from node 20 to node 2 to node 1. So the going back operation, the traversal operation in the reverse order is not possible in the singly linked list. That you should consider, right? Coming to the circularly singly linked list. This is a circularly singly linked list, right? So we know what a singly linked list is. A singly linked list consists of one address part, and that address will be locating or pointing to the next node address, that is pointing to the next node, right? So whenever you reach the end of the singly linked list, the address part is denoted by a null pointer. Is it true or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, right. Sir.
So
yes,
instead of this null pointer, what I will do is I will store the address part of the last node with the starting address. What is the starting address here? It is 100. Where I have stored this 100? I have stored this 100 inside the head. So I make the last node's address to point to the head. Therefore, I point like this. So what happens here? This node is again pointing to this first node. So this appears as if it is a circular linked list, right? So this is called as circular singly linked list, right? So it also provides access to the list from the head node only. So every linked list should have a pointer that always points to the head node. So in the circularly singly linked list also, there should be a head pointer which always stores the address of the first node. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So here the traversal is allowed only one way, and there is wrap up of the nodes. Wrap up means the last node is again connected back to the first node. This is called as wrapping. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now coming to the last next category of linked list, that is doubly linked list. Right. So by this word doubly means it has two links. It has two links. That means it can store, it is capable of storing two different addresses. So how many parts I have to divide the node? Right. As I told that three doubly linked list means it has two addresses.
Three parts.
So one part should be the value and one part should be the next address. And one part should be the previous node. So this is how we divide a given node into three parts. So the list or the node has two references. One reference is to the next node and one reference is to the previous node. Right, one to the next node and another to the previous node. Is it clear? And doubly linked list always starts, it also starts from head node only. So whatever linked list you take, whether it can be a singly linked list or circularly singly linked list or doubly linked list, the starting address or the first node's address should always be placed in the head node. So any operation on the doubly linked list also starts from the first node only. Therefore, the importance of head node you can understand from these points, right? So any operation on singly linked list, circularly linked, singly linked list, doubly linked list will always start with the first node, and you can identify the first node or you can access the first node by making use of the head pointer, right? But here you have to remember one important point, that the traversal is in both ways. So it can traverse in the right hand side or it can traverse in the left hand side also. So the programming of this doubly linked list is somewhat complex when compared to that of the programming related to the singly linked list, right? We need to manage two pointers for each and every node. Managing one pointer itself is a tedious task, but managing two pointers means you have to be very careful in writing the programs that are related to doubly linked lists, right? So this is one can traverse forward and backward. Since it has two pointers, one pointing to the next node and one pointing to the previous node, it is free to traverse in both the directions. So it can traverse in the right hand side and it can traverse in the left hand side also. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me what happens to the first node. This is my first node, right? I store the value of 10. And this is my second node. I store a value of 20. Assume that the base address is 200. And this is my third node where base address is 300. Now, what should be the next part of this node 1?
200, sir.
200, super. What should be the previous part of 100? This 10.
Null, sir.
So, it is null. So, what should be the previous part of node 2?
100.
What is the next part of node 2? 300.
300.
And this is
null.
Right. And you always store the address of this starting node in a pointer called head. Right. So, and the next category of linked list is circularly doubly linked list. We know what doubly linked lists are. So, every node consists of two linked parts or two reference parts. One reference is to the next node and one reference is to the previous node. This is very much clear. Right. And the second part is circular doubly linked list. Right. So, we need to wrap these nodes. So, in order to wrap these nodes, what you have to do? What should be the address part of the next part, next address part of this node 3?
100, sir.
Instead of null, you have to store
100, sir.
Therefore, I am able to link here. And tell me what happens to this null part, first node?
300, sir.
So, what should be the address of the previous address of the first node? So this node should be pointing to the last node. The last node address is 300. Therefore, instead of null, you have to store 300. So this is how you create a doubly, circularly doubly linked list. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So traversal is possible in both forward and backward directions. So these are the different types of linked lists we have, but most frequently we will be dealing only with the singly linked list. We have programming part in our theory that is related to only singly linked list, right? Theory subjects lo we have the programs. We need to discuss the programs related to singly linked list. That I will discuss in the next class, right? Now, how to design a node? Right? So in C programming language, you might have heard the term that called as structures. What is a structure?
Which collectively holds the data of different data.
So it is a collection, it is a data structure. It is a data structure which holds the various elements of different data types, right? So you might be heard of a term called self-referential structure. What do you mean by self-referential structure? Anybody, please tell me what do you mean by self-referential structure? I know what a structure is. It is a collection of elements of different data types, right? So what do you mean by self-referential structure? The name itself is saying that it is going to refer to itself. So that is the reason why we call it a self-referential structures. What do you mean by reference? It is nothing but an address or pointer, right? So self-referential structures means it is a structure where one of the members should be pointing to itself. Pointing to itself means it is pointing to the same structure. It is pointing to the same node data type, right? So how do you create a self-referential structure? Means here this is my node. I know how to represent my node, and this is the value part or data part, right? And this is address part. So what is this address? This address is nothing but the address of the next node. So I have another node, and I am going to store the address of this node into this, right? So I create a structure called node, in which it consists of two members. One member is the data part, this one, and the second member should consist of the address to the next node. That means it is the address of the same data structure, right? So you create a pointer called next, and it should be of type pointer to struct node. So whenever you refer to this pointer, that means it is capable, the next is capable of storing the address. So what address it can store? It can store the address of struct node, right? For example, if I say int star p, what is p here? What is p here?
Pointer.
Yeah, it is a pointer of type. What type it is?
Integer, sir.
Integer.
Integer. What do you mean by integer pointer? I told you in the class, basics is completed. What does the integer pointer store?
Address of the integer variable, sir.
So address of another integer variable, right? Super. When I say next, what is the data type of this next?
Structure, sir.
What is the data type of this next?
Struct nodes.
It is struct node, right? So it is a pointer to the struct node. Therefore, it can store the address of what address it can store? The next can store the address of
struct node.
Struct node.
It can store the address of struct node. So this particular member of this structure makes it a self-referential structure. Therefore, it is referencing. It is going to reference an element of same data type, right? Struct node is my data type, new data type that I have created. So I am going to store the address of that same data type, and I am accepting it as a member of that structure. Therefore, these type of structures are called as self-referential structures. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, how can I create a doubly linked list node? I know that it consists of three parts. One is the data part, another one is next part, and here we have previous part. So prev and next are the pointers which can store the address of previous node and next node respectively. So how do I create it? I create a node called struct node. It consists of the data part, therefore I declare the integer data like this. And it consists of next. What is this next?
Pointer to the next node, sir.
Pointer to next node. Therefore, I have to create a pointer of type struct node, and I am giving the variable name as next. Similarly, I have prev. What does this prev represent?
Address of the previous node.
Address of the previous node.
It is going to store the address of previous node, which is again a structure node, struct node. So I create a pointer to struct node, and I give it as prev. So this is how I declare a node in the doubly linked list. Right? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So these are the steps in creating a linked list. The first one is you have to declare a pointer to serve as the list head. As I told that there exists a pointer called head, which always stores the address of the starting node, right? So how do you create the head node here? What is this head going to store? And the address of the first node, right? So what should be the data type of this head? What should be the data type of this head?
Integer, sir.
It cannot be integer. I'm saying that the head can store the address of the first node. So if you are going to store the addresses, what is that you have to use? What concept you have to use? You have to use the concept of pointers. Right. And if you observe this head, the head is going to the store the address of the first node. What is the data type of this node? ఈ నోడ్ యొక్క డేటా టైప్ ఏంటమ్మా?
స్ట్రక్ట్ నోడ్.
ఇట్ ఈస్ స్ట్రక్ట్ నోడ్. ఇస్ ఇట్ రైట్ ఆర్ నాట్? ఐ యామ్ క్రియేటింగ్ దిస్ నోడ్ అండ్ ద డేటా టైప్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ నోడ్ ఈస్ స్ట్రక్ట్ నోడ్, రైట్? సో ఐ యామ్ గోయింగ్ టు స్టోర్ ద అడ్రస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ 100 విచ్ ఈస్ ఎ స్ట్రక్ట్ నోడ్ డేటా టైప్ ఇన్సైడ్ దిస్ హెడ్. సో వాట్ షుడ్ బి ద డేటా టైప్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ హెడ్? నౌ టెల్ మీ. Anybody please respond. If I want to store the address of an integer variable, I am declaring an integer pointer. If I want to declare the If I want to store the address of a floating point variable, I will declare a floating pointer. Similarly, if I want to store the address of a character variable, I will declare a character pointer. Now I am going to store the address of a struct node. So where I can store this address of struct node? What pointer I have to create?
Struct node pointer.
So you have to create a pointer of type struct node. So struct node star hat is equal to null. So initially I have created this head, right? What is the value I am storing here?
Address of first node, sir.
Okay, address of first node, but I have assigned it a value of null, right? So after you create the head node, assume that the head node is created at base address 50, head pointer. Right. Initially, I am assigning the value of null to this head. Therefore, what value is stored inside this head? It is null. Is it right or not? Mark, join the.
Yes, sir.
So here is the step one where I am creating a head node. Assume that these three nodes are not created. They are not created yet. First step is I have to create a head pointer. So I declare the head pointer as struct node and I'm assigning the value of null to this head node. Therefore, the assume that the node is created at address 50 and it is named as head and it consists of a value called null. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Once you declare the head pointer and you assign it to null, then it is clear that you have created an empty linked list. So you have created an empty linked list. Is it clear?
Yes,
so I never created these nodes. I have created only the head node and I have assigned it to null. Therefore, we can assume that you have created an empty linked list. Is it clear up to this point? After this, we'll move to the step two.
Yes,
step two is creating the first node. First node means assume that this is the first node. Right. So how I am going to create it? See here. So I know that the memory should be allocated by making use of dynamic memory allocation. Therefore, I have to use the malloc, clloc, and realloc. All these things I have to use. So memory must be allocated for one node and assigned to the head as follows. So I create a node. What is the data? What is the data type of that I am going to create here? What is the data type that I am going to create here?
Struct node, sir.
Struct node. So assume that I have type def it. What do you mean by type def? What do you mean by type def? So type def is nothing but giving an alias names to the already defined data types, right? So I want to, I don't want to write all the struct node. I simply want to name it as node. So what I will do is type def space struct space node node. So instead of writing this entire struct node, I am giving an alias name to this entire struct node as node, right? So here I am creating malloc size of node. So how much memory will be allocated for this node? Anybody? Please tell me. How much size will be allocated for this node? What is the struct node I have defined here? So what is the struct node I have defined here? Are you listening? మా ఉన్నారా?
ఆ ఉన్నా
సార్. Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Tell me how much memory will be allocated to this struct node.
Yes sir.
4 bytes sir.
It is not 4 bytes. What is the size of integer?
4 bytes sir.
4 bytes sir.
What about this pointer? How much memory will be allocated to this pointer?
4 bytes.
4 bytes sir.
So total how many bytes for this entire structure?
8 bytes.
So 8 bytes of memory will be allocated by making use of this malloc. Malloc functions IPN Yamiko. Do you have any idea on this malloc, clloc, and realloc?
లేదు సార్ అంటే విన్నాగానే అంత క్లారిటీ లేదు సార్ వాటి మీద.
Okay, then you should have an idea on this malloc, clloc, and realloc. So if time permits, I will tell you these topics also, dynamic memory management functions, where we will be discussing malloc, clloc, realloc, and free, right? So this malloc is a dynamic memory management function, is a predefined function which accepts one parameter, that is this node, right? What data type you need to allocate memory dynamically, that should be given in this one, right? Size of, have you heard of this size of?
Yes sir.
Right, what is this size of is used for? What is this size of is used? Size of endu use chestam. అమ్మా ఉన్నాడా మీరు? అట్లీస్ట్ తెలియస్తారా అని చెప్పండి అమ్మా.
ఇప్పుడు సైజ్ ఆఫ్ ఆపరేటర్ ఇచ్చేయడం వల్ల అది రిటర్న్ చేస్తారు సార్ వాల్యూని?
నో, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ రిటర్న్. సో ద నేమ్ ఇట్సెల్ఫ్ ఇస్ సేయింగ్ దట్ సైజ్ ఆఫ్
ఆపరేండ్ యొక్క సైజ్ రిటర్న్ చేస్తుంది.
So it is an operator, it is a special operator in C programming language that returns the size of the input that is given, right? So size of int ani ichanamma, what will it return?
4 bytes.
4, it will return 4, right? Size of float and ichen, it will return 4. Size of char and ichen, it will return?
1,
right? Now I have given the size of node, how many bytes it will return?
8 bytes.
So dynamically it will allocate 8 bytes here. Look at it. It will allocate 8 bytes and assume that the base address is 100 and the malloc function after it successfully allocates the memory for this node. So I am successful in allocating 8 bytes of memory. So what it will return is it will return the base address. What is the base address of this node? 100. Is it right or not?
Yes, sir.
So it will return the base address and I am assigning the base address to which where pointer? I am assigning this base address to?
Head pointer.
Head pointer, right? Connection line on. So I am assigning the base address to this head node. So what value is stored inside this head? Previously it has stored null value. Now I am this malloc function, it has successfully allocated 8 bytes of memory and the starting address is returned and it is stored in the head. So this null pointer, this null value will be overwritten and it will store the address of 100. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, how can I access this data part? So what does this node consist of? It consists of two part. This is data part. Right. What about this one?
Address part, sir.
And what is the name I have given here in my structure?
Next, sir.
So this is data and this is next. Right. So I want to access this data part. How I can access is head arrow data. Why do we use this arrow notation? When do we use this arrow notation? This is very important. This I have already discussed in the classroom when I am discussing the concept of structures, right? In structures, we have two variables. One is the normal structure variable and another one is a pointer to a structure. When I want to access the members, what are the members of the structure? What are the members of
data next?
Data and next. When I want to access the members of the structure using normal variable, what is the operator that I have to use?
Dot operator, sir.
Dot operator. Similarly, when I want to access the members of the structure through the pointer to the structure, what is the operator that I have to use? Arrow operator. Right. Now tell me, what is this head? Is it a pointer to the structure or not?
Yes, sir.
I have declared the head as a struct node pointer. Therefore, it is a pointer to a structure. So when I want to access the member of this particular node by using the pointer variable, what is the operator that I have to use?
Arrow operators.
So that is the reason why. What is this data here? Data and the end of my What is this data?
Actual value.
The value that contains in the node, sir.
No. What is this data means? It is a member of this struct node. Is it right or not?
Yes, sir.
Here in this structure, I have declared the member name as data. So it is a variable of type integer, and it is a member of the structure which stores the actual value. That is different case, right? But data is a member of the structure. So I am going to add, what is this head here? What is the head?
Pointers.
It is a pointer. You should not say it as pointer. You should always say it as pointer to which data type? Pointer to integer, or pointer to float, pointer to character, or pointer to struct node?
It is a pointer
to a struct node. So I am going to access the member data of the struct node using a pointer to the struct node. So what operator I should use? Arrow operator. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So head arrow data means I am going to access this part, this data part, and I am assigning it a value of 10. So I have assigned it, right? Now the next point is head arrow next. What does it mean? What is next here?
Address,
null, sir. What is next? First of all, tell me what is next.
Struct node pointer.
It is a member of the struct node.
It is a member of struct node. So far, right? What is head? We know that head is a pointer to the struct node. So I am going to access the next part. What is the next part? This one. You can see it, right? I'm going to access the next part, which is a member of struct node, by using a head pointer and by using the arrow operator. So head arrow next is equal to null. What does it mean? What does it mean? Head arrow next is equal to null. So head arrow next means this part, right? This part. Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So head arrow next is equal to null means here I am going to assign a value of null to this part. Right. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So how many nodes are there in my linked list now? How many nodes?
One.
Only one. When I create the head node, I am indicating that I have created an empty linked list. But when I create the first node, I am making the first node to point to the head node, such that I have only one node in my linked list. Right. Now adding second node. Let me create it. Adding second node. So anything you want to insert into the node, you have to create that node. How do you create that node? You have to create it dynamically. Whenever I say you need to create dynamically, you have to use the dynamic memory management functions. Right? So malloc, I know that malloc is a dynamic memory management function where I can allocate the memory. Right? Malloc size of node. Ikkada daaka me clear anamma?
Yes, sir.
What is this node again?
Yes, sir.
What is that node? What is that node? So it is an alias name I have used for the entire struct node. The entire struct node and tilchukune badlu, I have created an alias name. Instead of calling it as struct node, I can simply call it as node. Therefore, I am using a concept of type def here. So if type def is not supported, what is that you have to give it inside this size of? This size of lo em ivvalamma?
Struct node.
Super. Struct node. Instead of node, you have to give struct node. So I told that malloc is a dynamic memory management function which allocates the sufficient memory. How much memory? 8 bytes will be allocated. And assume that the node is created at base address 200. Right. So what is this part called? Data part. And what is this part called? Next. Right. and the base address is returned to the a pointer. Here I am creating another pointer node star next node. Jagratika enandamma node star next node. So what is this next node? What is this next node? Next node ante entamma amma, for example I give like this int star p. What is this p?
Pointer sir.
It is a pointer to integer, right?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
I am asking you, what is this next node?
It is a pointer, sir.
It is a pointer. Never tell that it is a pointer. It is a pointer of which data type?
Struct node, sir.
Struct node, sir.
Struct node, right? Node star. I am giving the alias name of node star as node, and I am creating a next node. So assume that it, the base address is 60 here. Jagratika enandamma. So next node, where this I have created an 8 bytes of location is created. And the base address is 200. And where I am storing this 200? The 200 and a base address and an address store chest na namma.
Next nodes. Next so, node of
No, I am storing it in the next node. So I have created a pointer. Can you see it in the screen? Right. Here I have created a next node. Assume that the base address is 60, and what does this next node stores? It stores the address of the newly created node, that is 200. Now how can I access this data part here? Ee data part nen ela store cheyachamma, ela access cheyali? Anybody?
Node where I access sir, sir.
So I can access this data part using the next node. Similarly, I can access this next part of this newly created node from this next node. Why? Because I am storing the address of this next node inside this. I am storing the address of this new node inside this next node. Therefore, I have to access this data as well as the next part using the next node only. So next node, what is data here? What is data?
Member of
it is a member of the struct node, sir.
It is a member of structure. And what is next node? It is a pointer to the structure. So I can access the member of a structure using pointer to a structure using arrow operator. So if I say next node arrow data, next node arrow data means I am going to access this location, this location, right? So I am assigning a value of 12 to it. So here I will write it as 12. Listen carefully. Next node of next. So I am accessing this part. And I have assigned a value of null to it. So it becomes null. So I have created a node already with a value of 10. Now I have created a new node with a value of 12. So I want to make this 12 node 2 as the last node. Therefore I have to make this next pointer pointing to null only, but I should link the first node with the second node. So what I have to do? I have to store the address of the second node. What is the address of second node?
200, sir.
200. I have to store the address of 200 inside the next part of the first node. But where this 200 is stored? It is stored inside next node, right? So I just make it like this. Head next is this one, right? Head next is equal to next node. Therefore I'm storing like this. So what happens here a link is created like this. So how many nodes do I have right now?
Two nodes, sir.
Right, one is at base address 100 and another one is at base address 200. Which is
200. 200, sir.
the node which is located at 200, right? Which is the first node?
The 100, sir. Have it, the node which is located at 100.
How can you identify that this is the first node?
The head is pointing towards the 100.
So, but the head is pointing towards the 100.
100. Right?
So this is how you create a link list. First of all, you have to create the head node. That means you have to create the empty list, and you have to create the first node. And from here onwards, you can create your nodes, any number of nodes. Right? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So the remaining part we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you, one and all. You can leave.
Okay, sir.
One minute. Let me take the attendance. Okay, you can leave on.